When you think of comfort and comfort food, the first thing that comes in mind is Rajma Chawal. So today's recipe is Rajma Chawal. Hello guys, welcome to Kolo's Yum Yums. To make the Rajma Masala, first we are going to cook the Rajma. So I have about 1 cup of Rajma. I have soaked it overnight. You need to at least soak the Rajma for about 8 hours, 6 to 8 hours, or overnight will be best. To this 1 cup of Rajma, I am going to add about 3 cups of water. Also going to add about 1/2 teaspoon of salt and 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric. Now why I am going to add less salt is because you are going to add salt to the gravy, the curry as well. So that's the reason I am going to keep the salt little low. Close and cook it for at least 6 to 8 whistles on high flame or on a very low flame for at least 4 whistles. That's how the Rajma will cook to nice mashable consistency, or else the Rajma is going to float if it's not cooked properly. So make sure your Rajma is really well done. While my Rajma cooks, I'm going to prepare the masala. For that, to this non-stick pan, I'm going to add about 2 tablespoons of ghee. Also, I'm going to add a very small piece of bay leaf, about 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds. Now, I like the flavor of jeera while biting into it. If you do not like jeera seeds, you can always add jeera powder, roasted cumin powder, or else you can add the jeera powder. Also, I'm going to add about 1 teaspoon of hing. Our jeera have started to splutter. I'm going to add about 1 medium-sized onion finely chopped. One medium tomatoes finely chopped. Five garlic cloves finely chopped and about 3 to 4 green chilies finely sliced. I'm going to let this cook for about 2 to 3 minutes. Now that our onions and tomatoes have softened, I'm going to add our seasonings and flavorings. To this, I'm going to add about 1 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 a teaspoon of turmeric, 1 heaped teaspoon of chili powder, 1 teaspoon of garam masala, and about 1/4 teaspoon of amchur powder. Now the tomatoes will not have that much tanginess, so that's the reason I'm going to add amchur powder. But if you feel your tomatoes are khatta or has nice tangy to it, so you can avoid the amchur. But my tomatoes are not tangy enough, that's the reason I'm going to add amchur powder in this. Now our Rajma has been cooking on the lower flame for about 20 minutes now. See, it's nice and well done. So I'm going to add the Rajma here. I'm going to mash up some Rajma. My Rajma has been simmering for about 1.5 hours now. See, it's nice and thick. The gravy has thickened really well. I'm going to serve it with some hot rotis, or you can even serve it with some long grain basmati rice, some jeera rice. The options are endless.
You guys are here already. I just couldn't resist by the smell of it. Rajma has become... Rajma is so yummy, so tasty. Guys, it's very simple and easy to make. Do try this at home. And before we sign out, do like, share and subscribe. And don't forget to comment. Let me know what you guys think. Now, I'm going to enjoy my Rajma Chawal. You guys also enjoy.